This Palmerstown FC Seniors video is powered by Ballon Sportswear. For amazing prices on team wear, equipment, team kits and more, visit www.ballondirect.com. Follow Ballon Sportswear on Facebook or Twitter using the hashtag @BallonSports. Palmerstown FC took on Cordorf on Sunday morning in the sunswept setting of Mill Lane. A lively opening to an evenly contested first half saw Dylan Sheridan the first to threaten for the hosts, before Nathan Johnston kept the visitors out at the other end. 11 minutes in, Seamus Daly's through ball found Gerard Kelly bearing down on goal. The impressive midfielder denied only by some excellent goalkeeping. The next chance of note came some 18 minutes in, as Cordorf centre-forward Paul Featherstone struck the outside of the post. The opening goal of the game arrived on 20 minutes. Excellent pressure applied from Carl Dempsey saw possession land at the feet of the mercurial Dylan Sheridan. Sheridan produced a pinpoint defence-splitting pass into the path of his brother Jordan, the frontman racing clear with blistering pace before producing a sublime finish. Cordorf will feel they should have levelled the game some 3 minutes before the second Palmerstown goal. Leon Rafferty, who cleared off the line minutes prior, played a key role in the goal. The defender's searching pass found Dylan Sheridan, who cut the ball back into the path of the on-rushing John Bushell. 2-0 Palmerstown. Within 55 seconds of the restart, Cordorf were back in the game. Some excellent approach play and a mix-up in the Palmerstown back line undoing the hosts. Matt Miller, who ended the first half with an attempt at goal, didn't have to wait long for his next opportunity. Within 43 seconds of the restart, superb play from Sean Dean down the left for Palmerstown and a neat layoff from Lee McNamara presented the frontman with a chance, one which he gratefully accepted. Miller and Lee McNamara will feel they should have extended the Palmerstown lead. Before John Don almost produced a goal to remember some 54 minutes in. By now, Cordorf were looking visibly tired. A wayward free kick the best to show for their efforts before Eric Mooney extended the Palmerstown lead to 4-1, following some good approach play and an assist from McNamara. A second goal in two games for the in-form Mooney. The game played out with chances at either end, resulting in no change to the scoreline. Full-time, Palmerstown FC 4, Cawdorf 1.